Coach Miller, and welcome to All Marine Fighter. Today, we're going to learn in our next series of punches the hook, the perfect hook. In fact, the hook can be done in various different situations and in various different types of combinations, and can definitely put a hurting on an opponent. We're first going to learn from the orthodox or right-handed stance, and then we'll learn from the southpaw or left-handed stance. Now, the hook can be done in different variations and make contact with different places on your opponent. But we're only going to cover the basic hook as it relates to some of the basic combinations that we're going to be doing. Look at our advanced boxing for more hook techniques. So you're going to start with the basic foundational boxing stance. Now, all the hook is turning the hips. Again, just like with the two, you're going to pivot the hips forward here. Power comes from the hips. And you're going to pivot the front foot. As you move your hips, your heel's going to flare automatically, okay? So here, and you're going to turn the glove in and come in. So you're slightly coming out, turn it in. Slightly coming out, turn in. Looking at the camera, here. Slightly turning out, turn in. You'll notice that my hips twist, power's generated from the body. Remember, you're not doing just upper body because you're going to get tired that way. You're pushing it and it's very slow. You want to do it with your body mechanics, proper body mechanics. So here, okay, out a little bit, turn in. Now, there's a couple different ways that you can throw the hook. Some teach the hook as in coming across like this with your forearm parallel and your knuckles turned over. Now, I understand this mechanic, and sometimes you can do this, but oftentimes you're only making contact with a certain portion of your knuckle and not the entirety of the knuckle. And also, you're at a difficult angle to make contact with somebody's jaw and not with the whole glove here, and you have a higher chance of breaking your knuckles. What I like to do, and there are many variations of the hook, like I said, and you can learn this also at the Olympic level, is you're gonna turn inwards. Turn inwards here. So you'll notice that my forearm is not completely parallel, although you could do that, but all it is a slight bending downwards. So it's not 45, it's in between 90 and 45, so right about here. You're gonna notice that you have a natural curling effect with the hook coming in. And when you make contact with, let's say, your opponent's jaw, you're gonna make contact with all knuckles instead of just a portion of them. Now, I'm not saying that turning it over just like this is wrong, but I'm saying I would definitely prefer to do this because of the natural body motion. Okay, in a left-handed stance, kind of the same thing here. Moving outwards, coming in. All right, and you notice I pivoted my heel on the front, on the lead foot, flared automatically. So here, right across a person's jaw, okay? And with that curling motion, you can feel a difference in the power compared to coming across like this. You notice that coming across, turning the knuckle over is a bit awkward. You can feel the power generated from your shoulders coming out this way, hands somewhat parallel to their face, the side of their face, okay? So from the left-handed stance, again, here, out, in. Now the hook is generally going to be in succession with various different combinations. But you can do the hook as a lead punch, and there are many famous boxers who did this, by the way. Roy Jones Jr. was called Captain Hook, for instance, because of his multiple hook attack. It was very dangerous. You can lead with a hook, especially when you're countering your opponent, but generally, you won't use it as your first punch. So it will come in succession with other punches. So you could be like a 2-3, for instance. So when you're throwing the two, okay, you're actually gonna be primed and ready to be able to throw the three already. Your body movement and body mechanics will already allow you to do that. And we have other punch combination videos with the hook to show those. So for this lesson, just remember that the hook can be done two different ways. You can have from the left-handed stance, coming in here where the arm is parallel, knuckles turned over, okay? Pivoting the hips, flaring the heel, or it can be done more where the knuckles parallel with the person's jaw, and same body mechanic of pivoting the hip and the heel just like this, okay? For the practical application for the hook, good solid orthodox stance and coming out, hook in, okay? You can turn over as well here and here. Out, in. While twisting the hips, flaring the heel, generating the power from the body. Left-handed stance. From a left-handed stance, here, out, in. Now you can throw a hook like this, but you're not getting the full range. The opponent, if the opponent's right here in front of you, it's gonna be kinda hard to throw a hook by just turning your jab hand in. So you naturally have to come outward a little bit. So come outward a little bit and then throw the hook in, okay? Like I said, the majority of the time, the hook is gonna be done following a lot of the combinations, which will already have you in position to be able to throw the hook. But if you throw the hook, especially if your opponent's against the ropes or something like that, just remember it's a small out and in with the punch. For the right hand in stance, small out and then in with the punch. If you like our videos, be sure to give it a like and please subscribe to our channel. Until next time, stay motivated.